message reaches every community, every nation. And that is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا. We have sent in every nation, in every community, a messenger. But that messenger does not have to reach every person in person. A person might hear the message and not see the messenger. The sixth issue, that the religion of the Prophet is one. All of them called to worship Allah Azza wa Jalla. The seventh issue, which is a major issue, is that the major issue is that the worship of Allah cannot be performed until Taghut is denounced and rejected. In this meaning is the saying of Allah, whoever disbelieves in the Taghut and believes in Allah, then he has grasped the most trustworthy handhold. فَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بِالطَّاغُوتِ وَيُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ اسْتَمْسَكَ بِالْعُرْوَةِ الْوُثْقَى. And that is, a person cannot become a believer unless he affirms that Allah is the only deity worthy of worship and negate any other deity from being worthy of worship. Everything that is worshipped with the permission of the worship is called طاغوت. And the eighth issue, لَأَكَنَّ الطَّاغُوتَ عَنْ فِي كُلْ مَا عُبِدَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ. الطَّاغُوتَ is general to everything that is worshipped other than Allah, but with one condition, that he is accepting this worship. Therefore, we do not call عيسى a طاغوت, even though the people worship him, because he does not allow that. He is not happy, nor he calls the people to do that. But the طاغوت calls the people to worship them, or to obey them at the expense of obeying Allah Azza wa Jalla. The ninth issue, عظم شأن ثلاث آيات المحكمات من سورة الأنعام. The importance of those three آيات in سورة الأنعام from verse 151 to 153. Also the tenth issue, the importance of the آيات in سورة الإسراء. And in the 18th issue, they are started with verses number 22 to verses number 39. We ask the students to go and read all of those, and we start with do not ولا تجعل مع الله إلها آخر. Start with ولا تجعل مع الله إلها آخر فتقعد مذموما مخذولا. And then it says, and this is what he brought in the book, وقضى ربك ألا تعبدوا إلا إياه. Then ayat surah al-Nisa, التي تسمى ayat الحقوق العشرة, also the ayat of surah al-Nisa where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said وَعْبَدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. 12, we must note the admonition of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which he made before his death. 13, to recognize Allah's right upon us, and that is to worship him. معرفة حق الله علينا. 14, معرفة حق العباد على الله إذا أدوا حقه. To recognize the rights of the slaves of Allah if they fulfill his rights. Number 15, أن هذه المسألة لا يعرفها أكثر الصحابة. This issue was not known to the most of the companions of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Reason being that Mu'adh said that right before he died. Number 16, جواز كتمان العلم للمسألة, permissibility to hide some knowledge for the common good. Sometimes we do not have revealed knowledge if people have no ability to understand it. Therefore it was reported by Ali ibn Abi Talib, he said, حدثوا الناس بما يعلمون, تريدون أن يكذب الله ورسوله. Talk to the people about issues that they can understand, otherwise they will attribute falsehood to Allah and to his messenger. Number 17, استحباب بشارة المؤمن بما يسره. It is desirable to pass the pleasing news to other Muslims. Fear, number 18, fear of dependence upon the expansiveness of Allah's mercy. We have talked about this. Number 19, to say, I don't know, to say, Allah and His Messenger know if you don't know. Number 20, it's correct to impart knowledge selectively to someone and not to others. Number 21, the humility of the Prophet on riding on a donkey with his the companion behind him. Number 22, it is legitimate to have a second rider behind him because both of them were riding on the donkey. The virtue of Mu'adh ibn Jabal, because the Prophet selected Mu'adh ibn Jabal to tell him this issue. عظم شأن هذه المسألة.